Mr. Speaker, for 2 years, the Minister of Finance hid his Morneau Chappelle shares in a numbered company, and we only found out about that because he got caught. He said he was working with the Ethics Commissioner from the beginning, but we know that's not true. He's been caught again, and he's under investigation yet again, and Canadians don't know what else he's hiding. The Prime Minister has said that sunshine is the best disinfectant. So will the Finance Minister let the sunshine in, face it with a grin, open up his books and let Canadians in on what else he's hiding? Yeah, yeah.
The Honourable Minister of Finance.
Mr. Speaker, to repeat, 100% of my assets have been disclosed from day one to the Ethics Commissioner. Mr. Speaker, what I can say is the opposition, focusing on personal tax, does not want to focus on the last decade in which they did nothing in housing. What we're talking about today is how we're going to make a huge difference in housing. The $11.2 billion that we set in Budget 2017 is going to make a significant long-term difference for Canadians. 500,000 people with a key to their own home or money to actually pay for their lodging. This is huge. We're going to reduce homelessness in this country by 50%. Mr. Speaker, we are on the job for Canadians, and we won't be distracted.
Honourable Member for Chilliwack-Hope.
Well, Mr. Speaker, at least on this side of the House, we can remember the homes that we own. For 2 years, the Finance Minister profited from his ownership in a company that made millions after he introduced legislation that benefited that same company. There was no blind trust. There was no sign-off from the Ethics Commissioner, and we only knew about his continued ownership with Morneau Chappelle because he got caught, and now he's under investigation yet again. Canadians want to know what other skeletons this minister is hiding in his closet, so when will he finally come clean, reveal what else he's hiding, so Canadians can see what his other conflicts of interest are?
Honourable Minister of Finance.
Mr. Speaker, I do understand why the members opposite want to focus on me. They don't want to focus on what's going on for Canadians. They don't want to consider how well our economy is doing, because of course it paints a very different portrait than what happened over the last decade. What we're seeing is the work we're doing, investing in Canadians, it pays off. Canadians are doing better. Families are doing better. We're seeing a huge benefit in Canadian families. More money in their pockets means our economy is doing better. We will continue to focus on improving Canadians' lives because we know, Mr. Speaker, that focusing on Canadians works.